Okay, Kyo, hi.
Hello, teacher.
Good evening. Okay, for today, we are going to wait for a while and it takes it. Okay, today we are going, the last time we had, we talked about articles and we had introduced reported speech, right? So now teacher will repeat what is reported speech. Again, teacher told you, reported speech is just like, I am talking, I say example. Okay, so we talk with each other. You will say, Teacher Anne, you know what? I am very busy today, yesterday, because I had my pet test. Oh, so I will say to your friends, you know what? Kyo said, okay, Kyo said he is very busy yesterday because Kyo has a test for cat. So I said, you know what? Kyo said. So that is reported speech. The moment you told me, teacher, I am very busy because I had the test. That is direct speech. You told it to me. But when I say it, Kyo, to other person, I say it to Jillian, I say it to your friend, to your mother, that is reported speech. Okay. Now we have to discuss more about the reported speech. Okay, Kyo?
Okay, teacher.
For a while.
The message of the speaker is reported in his own actual words or the exact words without any change.
Wait for a while. Okay, can you see now,
Kyo? For example,
Everything clear?
And this is how we write it in direct speech.
Can you see it? Can you see it, Kyo? Can you see it?
Yes,
okay.
I can see it.
Okay, let's start here.
Reported speech. This lesson describes the importance and differences between direct and reported speech. This also explains different ways and processes to be considered in converting or changing direct speech to reported speech and vice versa. Are you ready? Let's begin. Direct speech or coded speech. In direct speech, the message of the speaker is reported in his own actual words or the exact words without any change. For example,
is everything clear?
And this is how we write it in direct speech. We get the exact or actual words without changing it. Direct speech uses quotation marks. Clean the house. If we will write it in direct speech, the mother ordered clean the house. We use quotation marks to enclose the exact words of the speaker. Direct speech has reporting clause, reporting verb, reported clause, and reported verb. Let's see this example. I eat pancakes. The boy said, I eat pancakes. It has a reporting clause, a reporting verb, a reported clause, and a reported verb. That makes it a direct speech. Now let's see what reported speech is, or indirect speech. A reported speech is a report on what someone else said or wrote without using that person's exact words. For example, we can write this in a reported speech. John asked if everything was clear. We change is to was, and we added if. Therefore, we did not get the exact or actual words the speaker said. Another example is, the boy said he had eaten pancakes. We change I to he and ate to had eaten. So this is a reported speech because we did not get the exact or actual words the speaker said. Take note that in reported speech, the use of the word that is optional. Now let's learn the basic rules in changing direct speech to reported speech. First rule, changes in person of pronouns. First person pronouns, I and we, in reported clause are always changed according to the subject of the reporting clause. Examples, Anna said, I am happy. The pronoun I is in first person, so we need to change it according to the subject, Anna, who is a girl. So we need to use the pronoun she for our reported speech since our subject is a girl. For second person pronouns, like you, in reported clause are always changed according to the object of the reporting clause. Examples, Joy said to Paul, you passed the exam. Since you is in reported clause, which is a second person, we need to change it according to the object, which is Paul. And since Paul is a boy, we need to use the pronoun he. Third person pronouns like she, he, it, and they in reported clause are not changed. Examples, Joanna said she looks sad. Since we use she, a third person, in a reported clause, we need to use the same pronoun when we write it in reported speech because the rule says that we don't change it. Rule number two, changes in verbs. Let's talk about first the changes in the tenses of verbs.
Sa milk, di porkit mura sulit.
Check the label, mommies!
I-compare mo. Mas todo sa nutrients to. Ito lang ang may lactobacillus protect.
If the reporting verb
Sorry, Kyo, it's loading.
Difference says between
okay, again.
Direct and reported speech. This also explains different ways and processes to be considered in converting or changing direct speech to reported speech and vice versa. Are you ready? Let's begin. Direct speech or coded speech. In direct speech, the message of the speaker is reported in his own actual words or the exact words without any change. For example,
is everything clear?
And this is how we write it in direct speech. We get the exact or actual words without changing it. Direct speech uses quotation marks. Clean the house. If we will write it in direct speech, the mother ordered clean the house. We use quotation marks to enclose the exact words of the speaker. Direct speech has reporting clause, reporting verb, reported clause, and reported verb. Let's see this example. I ate pancakes. The boy said, I ate pancakes. It has a reporting clause, a reporting verb, a reported clause.
Okay. Sorry, Kayo. Okay.
And a reported verb. That makes it.
Okay. Okay, Kayo, we have here. So this is mainly the example of reported speech. Reporting clause, this is why the boy said. This is reporting clause. So reporting verb, said. Look at it in past tense, said. Another is, I ate pancakes. I ate pancakes. This is the reported clause. I ate pancakes. The reported verb here is ate. It's past tense. The reported verb again is ate. Okay? I ate. It's in the past tense. Okay, Kayo? Again, we have two forms as what it is said here. So, okay, let's repeat.
Okay, teacher.
Look at here.
And this is how we write it in direct speech. We get the exact or actual words without changing. Direct speech uses quotation marks. Clean the house. If we will write it,
clean the house.
The mother ordered.
The mother said.
Clean the house. We use.
Okay. Okay. Look at this one. Oh my God, Gia. Because I cannot move this. Okay, look at this one. So it is said here. Look at this is clean the house. Okay, clean the house. That's this is direct speech. Direct speech. Next is, you will have to say, direct speech, you will have to clean the house. That's direct speech. But if it is reported, the mother said, the mother ordered, clean the house. Can you see the word ordered? It is in the past tense. So now this is the, what we call, reported speech. This is the reporting verb. This is the reporting verb. Clean the house. Okay, I will exit down. Okay.
Quotation marks to enclose the exact words of the speaker. Okay. Direct speech has reporting clause, reporting verb, reported clause, and report verb. Let's see this example.
Look at that one.
I ate pancakes.
Ate pancakes.
The boy said, I ate pancakes. It has a reporting clause, a reporting verb, a reported clause, and a reported verb. That makes it a direct speech. Now let's see what reported speech is, or indirect speech. A reported speech is a report on what someone else said or wrote without using that person's exact words. For example, we can write this in a reported speech. John asked if everything was clear. We change is to was, and we added if. Therefore, we did not get the exact or actual words the speaker said. Another example is, the boy said he had eaten pancakes. We change I to he and ate to had eaten. So this is a reported speech. Because we did not get the exact or actual words the speaker said. Take note that in recorded speech, the use of the word that is optional. Now let's learn the basic rules in changing direct speech to recorded speech. First rule, changes in person of pronouns. First person pronouns, I and we in reported clause are always changed according to the subject of the reporting clause. Examples. Anna said, I am happy. The pronoun I is in first person. So we need to change it according to the subject, Anna, who is a girl. So we need to use the pronoun she for our reported speech.
Okay, look at this, Keo. In here, look at the first person pronouns is I, we. That's the first person. I, we. Remember that when we say first person, that is the one who talk about. Okay, that is the one who talk about. Who is the speaker? Again, first person is the speaker, like I. Okay, that is the first person, the speaker. Okay, in reported clause, are always changed according to the subject of the reporting clause. Okay, so again, in reported clause, are always changed according to the subject of the reporting clause. Look at the direct speech. This is DS, it's direct speech. Anna said, I am happy. Again, look at this one, direct speech. You can see, Keo, in direct speech, this is direct speech, you can see that there is quotation here. We call this, Keo, as quotation. There is quotation. Anna said, I am happy. Again, Anna said, I am happy. Okay, I am happy. Anna said, I am happy. That is direct speech. Okay, so, but when you say reported speech, okay, when you say RS, of course, what happened? Anna said that she was happy. Teacher, we use she here because Anna is, why? Because Anna is?
Anna is a girl.
Very good, Keo. Because Anna, Keo, is a girl. That is why we use, what is this?
She.
We use the she, teacher Anne. And look what happened. This is but look what happened with this. It becomes was. It's past tense, okay? It becomes past tense, Keo. Do you understand, Keo? Do you understand? Okay, very good, yeah. Anna said that she was happy, okay? Anna said that she was happy, okay?
Okay, teacher.
Okay, Keo, very good. Okay, now let's continue. This is in the first person.
Since our subject is a girl, for second person pronouns like you, in reported clause are always changed according to the object of the reporting clause. Examples, Joy said to Paul, you passed the exam. Since you is in reported clause, which is a second person, we need to change it according to the object, which is Paul.
Okay, look at the second person. We're done with first person. Look at the second person. It's you. So when we say you, second person, the second person, it is the person you are speaking to. Example, you and me. I am the first person. I am the speaker. I am the one who talk. Teacher Anne, you are the second person. The second person is the one whom I am speaking to. Again, I, Teacher Anne, is the first person, Keo. You is the second person. Do you understand, Keo? You understand?
Yes.
Okay, so you. In reporting clause are always changed according to the object of reporting clause. Look at this one. This is DS. This is DS, Keo. It's direct speech. Okay, can you see that one? This is DS, direct speech. Can you see? Again, there is quotations mark. There are quotations mark here. Joy said to Paul, you passed the exam. Okay. Next here, okay. Reported speech. Joy told Paul that he had passed the exam. Can you see he? So we use he because why, Keo? Why we use
because
he?
Because Paul is a boy.
Very good. Because Paul exactly is a boy, Teacher Anne. Yeah, because Paul is a boy, teacher. Okay, do you understand? You understand?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, next one, continue.
Since Paul is a boy, we need to use the pronoun he. third-person pronouns like she, he, it, and they in reported clause are not changed. Examples? Joanna said she looks at. Since we use she, a third person, in a reported clause, we need to use the same pronoun when we write it in reported speech. Because the rule says that we don't change it. Rule number two, changes in verbs.
Let's talk about first the changes in the tenses of verbs. If the reporting verb is in present tense or future tense, then no change is required to be made in the verb of report.
Okay, look at the third person here. Okay, in the third person, Keo, we have here she. She is if a girl. He, a boy. It, if it's a thing. It. And they. Many, they. They are close or not change. Okay, so of course, third person, again, what is first person? Speaker, Teacher Anne. Okay, Teacher Anne.
Okay.
Second person, Keo. Third person, we are talking your mother. Your mother is the third person. I will say, Keo, your mother is beautiful. Okay. I am talking to your mother. Me, first person. Second person, we talk. Second person, your mother is the third person. Okay? So, what is your mother? Boy or girl?
Girl.
Okay. So, your mom is a... Your mom is a girl.
Yeah.
So therefore, your mom is a girl. We will use she, okay? Like Joanna, okay? Joanna said she looks sad. Joanna said she looked sad. So this one, she, it refers to Joanna, which is a girl. Okay, do you understand that? Joanna is a girl, okay? Next, continue.
That we don't change it. Rule number two, changes in verbs.
Let's talk about first the changes in the tenses of verbs. If the reporting verb is in present tense or future tense, then no change is required to be made in the verb of reported clause.
This verb could be in any tense. For example, he says, I am going to the library. Since the reporting verb here is says, which is in present tense, we don't change it when we write it in reported speech. If the reporting verb is in past tense, then the reported verb will be changed depending on its tense.
Okay, for a while here.
This verb could be in any tense. For example, he says, I am going to the library.
Since the reporting verb here is says, which is in present tense, we don't change it when we write it in reported speech. The reporting verb is in past tense, then the reported verb will be changed depending on its tense. And here are the rules on the tense of verbs. We change present simple join to past simple joined.
Okay. Look at Keo. Direct speech, DS, this DS, and RS, or reported speech. The present simple, the man said, I joined the club. Past simple, the man said that he joined the club. Okay, again, the man said, I joined the club. Past simple, the man said that he joined the club. He joined the club. This is what the man said. Okay? Okay, Keo?
Okay, teacher.
Okay. So, can you see this is present, it becomes past here. This is present, it becomes past here. Okay? Can you see the difference?
Yes.
Okay. Next one here. She said the cat is sleeping. Look at in the past progressive tense, was sleeping. Always remember, Keo, when we talk about progressive tense, if there is ing. Okay, there is ing. Okay, that is in present progressive tense. There is ing. Okay?
Okay, teacher.
Okay. And it, of course, it's changed because we are talking here past. Present tense, it becomes past tense. Join, it becomes joined. Is sleeping, it becomes was sleeping. Okay.
From present progressive, is sleeping, to past progressive, was sleeping. Next, from present perfect, have prepared, to past perfect, had prepared. From past simple, started, to past perfect, had started. Next, from past progressive, were laughing, to past perfect progressive, had been laughing. And for past perfect, we don't change it if we are going to write it to recorded speech. So rewrite had studied the same. Next, modal had verbs. Studied. We change will or shall to would or would. Should.
Okay.
And can.
Of course, when you say the same thing, if you use modal verbs, Keo, if you are going to use modal verb, the same thing, will, which it would or should. Okay, it becomes past. Can, it becomes could. If you try to use this, like say, Brian said, I will try to finish my report. Brian said that he, okay, we use he because, why? We use he because Brian is a boy.
Brian is a boy.
Brian said that he would try to finish his report. Okay, he would. Okay. Next, my father said to me, I can pick you up. Look here, my father told me he could pick me up. Okay, so can you see that? The present, the modals in the present, it becomes past tense.
Can to could. We also change may to might. And must or had to. Number three, other significant word changes. Here are some of the examples. We change now to then, here to there, today to that day, tomorrow to the next day, yesterday to the day before, tonight to that night, and these to those. Number four, conversion of interrogative and imperative direct speech. The reporting verb said or said to is changed to asked, demanded, or inquired since interrogative is a question. For a yes-no question, if or whether is used in place of that. For example, Joseph said to Jana, will you attend the flag ceremony? Since will you attend the flag ceremony is a yes-no question. We are going to change said to asked and use if instead of that.
Okay, can you see that, Keo? Okay, if yes. In case it's interrogative, what do you mean by interrogative? Ask question. You ask question, interrogative. It means you ask questions. For a yes or no questions, if or whether is to use in place of that. Okay, for a is to use in place of that. Okay, that is yes or no questions. Okay, DS, Joseph said to Jana, will you attend the flag ceremony? Okay. Direct speech. This direct speech. Joseph said to Anna, will you attend the flag ceremony? Look at this. There is a question mark here because we are talking here about interrogative. It is question form. You ask question. Okay. Reporting speech. Joseph asked Jana if she would attend the flag ceremony. If. So, in interrogative, Keok, you can see, in interrogative, okay, the question, Keok, it becomes, okay, the question, Keok, it becomes, okay, there is if. Okay. Joseph asked Jana if she would attend the flag ceremony. Again, Joseph asked Jana if she would attend the flag ceremony, if she would attend the flag ceremony, okay?
Okay.
You can see that always remember if interrogative, if it is question form, if you ask question, Keo, you will have to use reported speech. There is F. But in reported speech, it will not be question anymore. Like this. Joseph said to Jana, will you attend the flag ceremony? In reported speech, kayo, there is no question. No question mark. No. There is no question mark in reported speech. It becomes, Joseph asked Jana if she would attend the flag ceremony. There is F, but there is no question mark. Okay, continue. You understand, kayo?
Yes, teacher. I understand.
Okay, very good. Okay.
For a WH question, neither if is used nor any other word is added. For example, my little brother said to the waitress, what are you doing? Since what are you doing is a WH question, we need to change said to ask, and we don't need to add if or any other word since this is a WH question.
Okay, for WH question like what, who, why? Okay, my little brother, look at indirect speech in the S. My little brother said to the waitress, what are you doing? Look at this one, this WH question, what? What is WH question? So if WH question, what will happen? My little brother asked. Instead of saying said to, you will have to tell asked. My little brother asked the waitress what she was doing. Asked. My little brother asked the waitress what she was doing. Okay. Instead of using, okay, where is it? Why?
Yeah.
Okay. Instead of saying said to, you will have to use asked. Okay, Kayo? Okay? Okay, very good. Next one here.
For imperative or command, the reporting verb said or said to is changed to ordered to or commanded to. For example, the librarian said to me, keep quiet. Since keep quiet is a command, we need to change said to ordered to. For imperative requests, the reporting verb said to or told is changed to requested to. For example, he told me, please call me. Please call me is a request. Therefore, we can change told to requested to since this is a request.
Okay, Okay, wait that here. It means imperative, you request. You will have to say, please, Kayo, you will have to request something. Okay, so in imperative or request, the reporting verb said to or told is changed to requested to. Okay. He told me, please call me. Okay. Look at that one. Okay. Request, you will have to say please. That's request. Okay. So he requested, look at this one, Kayo. Again, he told me, please call me. Okay. The request here is please. So in reported speech, in RS, it becomes he requested instead of saying he told, he said to, no. You will say he requested me to call him. Or you will say, Kayo told me to get water. Okay. Kayo requested me to get water. Don't forget to use the word requested to because we are in imperative. We ask request. We ask favor. We say please. Okay? Okay, Kayo?
Okay?
Kayo?
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Next one here. The activity. Wait for a while. Okay, here, I will give. The activity for reported speech. One. 4, 5, 6, 7. worksheet. Okay, look at this. Okay, Keo, this one, please try to make this activity. Okay, sorry. Can you see this, Keo? Can you see?
Yes.
Okay, for a while.
Perfect English grammar.
Okay, why it's too big? Okay, this one, please try to answer. Change this direct DS into reported speech. You write your answer here, okay? Just put your answer here, Keo, just here, okay? Just think. Okay, look at this, Keo. She said he worked. Yeah. Look at past tense. Okay, don't forget.
He worked.
Oh, worked.
the two last words.
Okay, number three, I'm coming, she said. She or he? What? Okay, just guess. You try to answer.
Yes. Teacher, what? I don't know the two last words.
Okay, it's okay. It's okay. The task okay here. We have here.
Okay.
It's too many. Okay, number one, we have what we answered? One and two only, right? You answered one and two. He worked in the bank and they went out last night. Let us answer here. Look at this one, Keon. In number one, okay, she said that he worked in a bank. Very good. She told me that she went out last night. Okay, that's it. So tomorrow, Keo, we will have to continue this one. We'll continue answering this one. Okay, can you see that? We will continue answering this one. Okay. Okay, Keo.
Okay.
Okay. So. Okay. So for now, okay. Where is Keo? I lost. Where is Keo? Okay. So for now, teacher will say goodbye, and I will be seeing you tomorrow. Ah. Tomorrow, we don't have class because teacher Anne don't have time on Tuesday. So, I will be seeing you on Wednesday, okay? Okay, Kyo?
Okay, teacher.
Okay, bye-bye, Kyo boy.
Okay. Bye, teacher.